In Iran, the mullah's policy of veliyat-e faqih, or absolute clerical rule, allows them to justify every horror, every medieval torture, every public execution, every act of terror as the will of God. For 39 years since the Iranian Revolution handed power to Ayatollah Khomeini of the Detainees in Iran, the UN must raise its voice against human rights.
And that is because the human rights situation in Iran has deteriorated dramatically over the past few months. And it has further blackened the very dark picture. During the nationwide protest, more than 8,000 people were arrested, 50 people killed, 13 murdered in custody. The Iranian regime has claimed that they committed suicide in prison.
Its penal code and constitution that the mullahs have imposed on the people justifies barbaric punishments like amputations, floggings, public hangings, and stoning. These atrocities are well documented by the UN Special Rapporteur on Iran.
More than 14 people were executed, and the reason for their execution, apparently, according to the regime, either they are drug addicts and they committed suicide, or they are simply people who regretted their action, and for that reason they committed suicide.
È uno dei pochi paesi del mondo che ancora applica la pena di morte ai minorenni in violazione delle leggi internazionali. I difensori dei diritti umani, gli attivisti per i diritti umani e quelli contro la pena di morte vengono considerati nemici dello Stato. Per anni ci è stato detto che una fazione moderata stava crescendo all'interno del regime. Ci è stato detto che i riformisti stavano prendendo il sopravvento.
So it is time for the Secretary General of the United Nations, and I believe it's on his agenda, to introduce...
On NCRI's website, ncr-iran.org, it's a brilliant summary and analysis of the situation in Iran after the uprising.
To Syria, but also in relation to the activity, the Iranian activities there, I must emphasize, said the High Commissioner, that what we are seeing are likely war crimes and potentially crimes against humanity. The perpetrators of this crime...
...about freedom and democracy in Iran, the West must stand with them. We must stand on the right side of history. The international community creates actions and policies...
Thank you.